It's Tuesday, and that means one thing. We are talking finances and money. Our good friend Les Szarka is here with some important year-end tips on dealing with recent tax law changes. I didn't know anything about this, Les, and I'm so glad we're talking to you about it. There were several changes to IRAs and 401ks earlier this year. Why don't we start with the IRAs? What's going on here?
So there are some changes at the beginning of the year, and with all the distractions that we've had, it was probably easy to miss. So I figured it'd probably be beneficial to quickly go over these. So the three major changes were, one is that they suspended having to take out of your IRA for 2020. So if you're 70 and a half, you had to take out a certain percentage of your IRA or 401k. That you don't have to do for 2020. The market crashed, and so, again, the government just said, okay, fine, this year, if you don't need the money, just go ahead and not take it out. The second one is they extended out the age to 72 that you have to start taking out of your IRA. So they took it from 70 and a half to 72, but that only applies to people that are turning 70 and a half this year. So if last year you were 71, you still have to take it out for this year. And then the third one was more on for an estate planning issue. And that's that whoever inherits your IRA eventually, so not your spouse gets continuation, but when your kids or grandkids inherit it, in the past, they could defer paying taxes on the majority of it over their lifetime. And then if they had money left over, they could pass it on to their kids, you know, your grandkids. Now you have to take it out within 10 years of the person passing away. So those are the three big changes that happened earlier this year.
Uncle Sam trying to help us all out. That's pretty nice stuff. What about the 401ks? What are the changes there?
Well, the 401k really is only affected if you're still working and you're over the age of 70. So there weren't really any major changes to the 401k unless, again, you're retired and you left the 401k, your money in the 401k at your previous employer. So those rules are the same as if it was for your IRA account.
Okay, not as big there. But what about our viewers now? What should they be doing as they look over their portfolio thinking, you know, maybe there is a chance, there's an opportunity here before the election, before the end of the year for tax benefits? What should viewers be doing right now as they look at their money?
Well, the first thing is, and we're getting a lot of questions on this because people are getting letters from the, you know, their IRA provider saying, hey, listen, you know, we're coming towards the end of the year. You don't have to take out if you don't want to, if you're over 70 and a half. So the first thing would really is, you know, do you want to take it out or not? So if you're in a position where you need the money to live on, then obviously you would just continue to take it out. But there is a unique opportunity for those folks that don't necessarily need the money this year, because again, from a tax savings perspective, if you don't take it out, then you don't have to pay tax on it and you can defer it, you know, to later on. So it really comes down to that income planning, or even if, let's say, you know, usually take out at the end of the year as a lump sum, you know, to supplement income for next year, you may want to defer that into next year's tax year as well. Or, you know, maybe draw more heavily on your non-retirement accounts if you have any mutual funds or CDs or things like that. So there's some careful and interesting tax planning you can do. But then also for the fact that, you know, the 10-year rule that I just mentioned, where after you pass away, they have 10 years to take it out. There's some longer term tax planning that gets involved in there. It gets a little bit more complicated because in the past, you know, if your tolerance for paying taxes was pretty decent, then we'd say, fine, you know, just go ahead and let the IRAs defer, and then someone else will pay it at a later date. Now we're looking at it saying, well, if those beneficiaries have to take it within 10 years, you actually might be better off taking more heavily there and let your non-retirement assets, you just continue to cook, because there they get a stepped up basis. So what that means is, let's say if you bought $100,000 of Apple and then you pass away and now it's worth $300,000, your kids don't pay any income tax on that. They get a stepped up basis. So there's some really interesting tax planning issues that come into play. So I would just encourage people that if you're in a higher tax bracket, talk to somebody to take a look at, you know, are there any potential tax planning issues that you want to take advantage of because of these new tax rules?
The waters of handling the money, they're tough to navigate without professional advice like Les Szarka.
Yep.
Thank you, Les. Pleasure as always, man. We'll see you in a couple days. Always good stuff. I love the way you break things down conversationally that we all can understand. Folks, if you have financial questions or need more information on Szarka Financial Services, you can head over to our website, fox8.com, and click on Seen on TV. He's with us every Tuesday and Fridays and weekends too. Good stuff there. Professional advice, free for you this hour.